Today, we're going to talk about Canon's EFS 10-18mm wide lens. And this might be the best lens to use for vlogging, both on a cropped sensor camera and a full-frame sensor camera. Coming up. Holding the lens, you feel how light it is. It might not feel like a professional high-end lens due to the fact that it's made out of plastic. But being a lightweight lens, it's not a bad thing if you're going to use this thing for vlogging. If you are carrying around a camera and a lens and holding it up to get a vlogging video of your day, you do want a lighter lens so you don't hurt your arm and shoulder. Now, it might feel cheap, and frankly, it is. This is Canon's cheapest wide-angle lens, coming in at only $299 on B&H.com. But even with the budget price and cheap feeling, this is still a durable lens. Since it is an EFS lens, it is a lens made for a cropped sensor camera. Because of that, we have to take the crop factor into mind when looking at the full frame equivalent. If you never heard about crop factor and want to learn more about it, I made 4 videos about the differences between crop sensor cameras and full frame sensor cameras. And if you watch part 1 of those videos, you will know what crop factor is. So the 10-18mm on a cropped sensor lens, that is a full frame equivalent of a 16-28.8mm lens. Now, if we take a look at the full frame lenses to match the EFS 10-18mm, we have the EF16-35 f4. That lens comes in at $999, and that's with a $100 discount at the filming of this video. So that's quite the difference in price. So for someone just starting out and wants a good wide angle lens at a budget price, the EFS 10-18mm, it's a good option. You can also use the EF 10-18mm lens on a full frame body with an adapter, like on my EOS R. In 4K, the EOS R has a crop anyway, so you won't lose any quality, resolution, or focal length. For photography, it's a little bit different. Here, the camera will crop in on the full frame sensor and only use the APS-C portion of the sensor. So you will lose some megapixels when snapping a photo with this lens on a full frame EOS R. But that's not to say that you can't get good images out of that combination. And for the Canon EOS R5 and R6, you just go into the APS-C mode or crop mode on those cameras. But for vlogging, the lightweight of the EFS 10-18mm lens makes it easier to use a more heavy full frame body. Because of the aperture number on the lens and that it is a variable aperture, running from f4.5 at the widest 10mm and darkening when zooming into 18mm at f5.6, this lens is not the best lens when it comes to low light situations. This lens shines best when the sun shines. That's not to say that you can't use it in low light situations, you just need a camera that can handle the high ISO settings. With a more closed down aperture, you won't get that blurry background and fine bokeh that wide open prime lenses can give you. But again, that's not to say that you can't get blurry background. You just have to know about the different factors that impacts shallow depth of field and use that to your advantage. when filming on bright sunny days to utilize the aperture you have on the lens. A variable ND filter is a good idea to put on this lens, so you don't have to stop it all the way down to get the correct exposure. The fact that it is an EFS lens makes this a better option for the M50 and M6 Mark II than the native wide-angle EF M11-22mm does. In my opinion. Now you may think, how so? Well, there are a couple of reasons for me thinking that. And number one, you have the option of still using this lens on other camera bodies if you someday make the decision to leave the M system. Like we already said, as it is an EFS lens, you can use it on a full frame body just by putting it on an adapter. For now, there is no option of using native EFM lenses on any other camera body than the EOS M bodies. And number two reason is that there is a price difference also. The EFM 11-22mm, it comes in at $399. That's a $100 difference. Yes, you do need an adapter to put the 10-18mm on your EOS M body, but investing in an EF to EFM adapter will benefit you since it opens up the option of using all of Canon's EF and EFS lenses. And since there are not that many EFM lenses out there to choose from, getting the adapter is a good one-time investment in my opinion anyway. So I don't think we can calculate the cost of the adapter into the cost of the EFS 10-18mm lens. So it is a cheaper lens than the native 11-22mm lens. And number three, there are rumors that Canon is going to kill off the EOS M system soon. Now, this is only a rumor, but me personally, by the fact that this rumor is out there, I'm not buying any new EFM lenses because I don't want to be sitting around with a bunch of EFM lenses when they sooner or later decide to cut it out. So I think it's better to buy lenses that can be used on multiple camera bodies, and that's my opinion. Using the lens at 10mm when vlogging, you don't just get your face in the frame, you also get more of your background in the frame, so your viewers get a better impression of the environment that you're in. Using the lens at the widest 10mm, you will get some distortion in the edges, but I guess that's the vlogging look you might be wanting. As wide as the lens is, it's a good lens to use in tight spaces, and it's perfect for landscape photography as you get a lot of the scenery in the frame. And it's also a really good lens for real estate photography. The lens has image stabilization. There's a switch on the side of the lens next to the auto to manual focus switch that you can turn on and off. You can see the effect of the image stabilization in this footage. Here I'm hand holding the camera and IS is turned off. You can see the small movements I'm making even though I'm trying to hold the camera as steady as I can. When we turn on the IS, all the small movements disappears and it's really effective. And I gotta say, that's impressive for a plastic budget lens like this. This lens also have STM motor when it comes to the autofocus. STM means that it features Canon's stepper motor technology. This is a system that allows for near silent focusing during video recording. So your microphone, it won't even pick up any noise as the lens changes the focus. And that's excellent for video making. Overall, I think that this is a lens that everybody should have in their camera bag. it's nice to have a lens that doesn't cost that much, but still opens up really wide to just throw onto the camera and it still gives good quality images. It's a good lens both for photography and videography. And the fact that you can use this lens on both EOS M, DSLRs and full frame mirrorless EOS R cameras, I think that this is only a plus in my book. So I highly recommend the EFS 10-18mm IS STM lens from Canon. So that's the video for this week. I do hope you got something out of this video. If you did, click that like button and that subscribe button too if you want to see more videos from me. So as I said, that's the video for this week. Maybe I will see you in another video. Bye.